vitamin B1, the mystery vitamin. I'm going to tell you in this video what it is, what it does, and why it's the mystery vitamin. Now, it's not the Scooby-Doo show. It's not that kind of mystery. It's just a mystery because it's difficult to tell when you are deficient because it has such a wide range of symptoms that they can very easily be confused with just about anything else. So welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. And let's get into it. Vitamin B. Thiamine is the compound that we call vitamin B1. And it is responsible for converting your food into energy. So it's very important in the mitochondria of your cells, if you're a science geek like me, otherwise it doesn't matter. And it plays a crucial role in cell function, particularly in your autonomous nervous system. That's the part of your nervous system that you're not aware of. So the things that work automatically, like your bladder and your digestion and your heart. So you can tell then that if you're short, those are the areas where you're likely to have problems. Now, it's a water-soluble vitamin, which means you pee it out if you don't use it. So you need to have vitamin B1 in your food every day. It's an essential vitamin. You have to get it from your food. Your body cannot make it for yourself. So you don't store it. You can't build it up. So you can become deficient quite quickly. Now, I've got a list down here of symptoms, and I'm going to have to keep looking down at my page because the list is huge. Listen to this. I'm also going to write them out in the video description, okay? I'll bullet point them there so you can go and have another look at them. But listen to the things that you might experience if you're short of vitamin B1, and tell me if you can see even one that might not actually just mean you're short of something else. And this is why it's the mystery vitamin. Okay, tachycardia. Okay, that's a heart rhythm issue. That could just be electrolytes, salts. Weight loss, unexplained weight loss. Can be a lot of things. Breathlessness, confusion, memory loss, bad balance, muscle weakness, numb or tingling feet, bladder issues, irritation. That just might be somebody in your family. And temperature regulation doesn't work. So you could be too hot or you could be too cold. If you have a really severe deficiency, you get beriberi, which is the disease, which is quite common in undeveloped countries where the nutrition is particularly bad. And in addition to those symptoms, people have seizures and vomiting and anorexia. And so it can be really severe. But the level of deficiency that we tend to find in the West, it's unusual for someone to have beriberi, but all those other symptoms are quite common. And it's very difficult to pinpoint because you can't do a blood test for B1 either. So what do? You have to use a little bit of common sense and say, all right, is it likely that I'm going to be short of vitamin B1? So here is another list of risk factors. Okay, these are people who might be more likely to be short of vitamin B1. So listen to this list and see if you fit in to one of these categories. And this will also be written in the show notes down here under the video. Okay, so here we go. If you're losing a lot of body fluid through diarrhea or vomiting or from peeing, now not sweating, so it's got to come through your digestive system. So through the bottom, through the top. Diarrhea, vomiting. If you're peeing a lot because you're on diuretic, it could be flushing out your B1. If you have a high level of alcohol intake, you could be flushing it out because alcohol is a diuretic. So alcoholics, for example, are typically very deficient in vitamin B1. And if you're on dialysis, if you have kidney problems and you're on dialysis, that can flush the vitamin B1 out of your system. If you are not taking enough vitamin B1 in your food, so if your vitamin B complex generally intake is quite low, and at particular risk of that would be vegans or vegetarians, because most of our vitamin Bs come from animal products, so which is why a lot of vegans who understand this will be on a vitamin B supplement, so that's fine. If you are obese or pre-diabetic, or if you have diabetes, you are going to be at high risk. People who are pregnant are at high risk. And then there are certain medications, some cancer medications, and then other medications like metformin and antibiotics, which interfere with the absorption of B1. So you might be eating plenty, but not getting it because of the medications you're on. So look at this list down below, see if that's you, if you're obese, or if you're on metformin, or if you're diabetic, or if you are taking a diuretic for any reason, or if you've been ill and you've been vomiting and you've had an upset stomach, you could be low on vitamin B1. Then go look at the symptoms and see if you have any of those. How do you fix it? Well, it's not difficult. You can fix it with food. You just have to make sure you're eating the foods that contain vitamin B1. And those are meat, pork in particular, but all meat, fish, nuts, dairy products, and then, funnily enough, sunflower seeds are quite high in vitamin B1. Now, there are other foods that have been fortified by the manufacturers with vitamin B1, and you often see it on the packaging. You'll see whole wheat bread that says contains extra vitamin B1, but then you're eating processed foods, processed carbohydrates, sugars, starches, which you want to be staying away from anyway. So the best way to get vitamin B1 from your food is to eat proper whole foods that contain vitamin B1 naturally, not processed foods that have had vitamin B thiamine injected into them. Or you could take a supplement. Okay, now if you're going to take a supplement, be careful. Thiamine is vitamin B1. So take a thiamine supplement. There is a supplement called benfothiamine, which people will say will market it as B1. It isn't. Benfothiamine is a synthetic version of B1. It's been produced in a lab. It's a chemically produced, and it is a fat-soluble compound. It's not the water-soluble natural vitamin B1. It's not thiamine. And your body has to convert it to thiamine after you've taken it. So just get a thiamine supplement if you want a supplement. You only need about 100 milligrams a day. It's not a big thing. What I would suggest to you if you are suffering from any of these symptoms is just give it a try. Take 100 milligrams of thiamine once a day for a week or something and see if you get better. And if you do fix yourself, then you know that's what it was. Then look at your food, see what you're lacking, adapt your lifestyle, cut down the alcohol, maybe you need to lose weight, and you can address it so that you don't have to take supplements for the rest of your life. A supplement should be a temporary thing until you can adjust your lifestyle or adjust your diet and get the right foods to get the vitamins that you need. Now, just one thing. If you are going to do a thiamine or a vitamin B1 supplement, because so many of these symptoms are similar to what you would experience if you had a magnesium deficiency, and go and watch my video on magnesium. I'm going to link it here or here, or I'm going to put a link to it in the video notes down below. I did a video on magnesium that explains the symptoms of a magnesium deficiency and what you can do for it. I would suggest that you, if you're going to supplement to see if you're B1 deficient, just supplement with magnesium as well. So if you fix your problem, you know it was B1 or it was magnesium. At least you've fixed it. Then look at your diet and then you can cut back again on the supplements. My mum had, she won't mind me telling you this, she had night bladder problems in her 80s. 90s, what am I talking about? She's well into her 90s. Some of you know her. We put her on a B1 supplement and now she sleeps through the night with no problem. So it was an easy fix for somebody even in her 90s. And the quality of life was obviously massively improved. Not only is she getting more sleep, but emotionally that is a big issue as well. So there you go. The mystery vitamin is not really such a mystery. It's just once you can figure out what it is, it's easy to fix. The foods are simple. The supplement is simple. You won't overdose it. You can't do that. You will just pee it out if you have too much. But just take a 100 milligram supplement of thiamine and fix your vitamin B1 problem. Thank you very much for your time. Please like the video. Please subscribe to the channel. And please share this with anybody you think sounds like they've got any of these symptoms, because it could just be a simple matter of a deficiency of vitamin B1.